I hate, hate, hate losing my place every time I move my eyes away from a data range in Excel. Maybe you're better at this than I am, but when I'm trying to compare entries from various files or applications, it twists my brain into a pretzel and I feel like a sloth speeding toward a deadline. And if I had never learned this simple Excel trick to highlight my active rows and columns, I'd still be living in a Where's Waldo world of data. Of course, you could certainly hide the surrounding rows and columns, but what I'm going to show you today offers a more direct and speedy approach to bookmark your view. For my fellow data people with a multi-screen focus issue, the next 5 minutes will teach you the Excel hack you never knew you needed. To highlight the active cell in a data range, which is the selected cell indicated by the border around it and the reference in the dropdown, we must apply some conditional formatting. Obviously, you can simply highlight the row you're working with and fill it with some color, but it's not very efficient. This requires more steps than needed, and the constant applying and removing colors as you work through the data will get old fast. So the first thing we want to do is highlight the range of data. Now, you could choose to select the entire sheet, and this would work just as well, but the highlighted sections would continue through unused columns. Instead, let's select only the range by clicking anywhere in the data and pressing Control A. Now open the conditional formatting dropdown under the Home tab and select New Rule. We want to use a formula to initiate our new rule, so choose the last rule type in the window. In the formula bar, we'll type in a function that tells Excel when to trigger the format. For highlighting the row containing the active cell, the formula is equals cell followed by open and close parentheses with the word row in quotes between them. Then set that to equal the row function. In simple terms, this formula checks for the row of the active cell and returns the row number. With some formatting, the return row can be emphasized more clearly. In this case, I'll pick a fill color to highlight the active cell when it's selected. Hit OK twice and let's test it out. So we see the active cell row is highlighted, but when I click a different row, nothing happens. Unfortunately, Excel needs us to update its recognition of an active cell. To do that, press F9 to force the update. Since efficiency is kind of the main point, we can make this update occur automatically with a little bit of VBA. Nothing too complicated, I promise. You can either open the Developer tab and select the Visual Basic icon, or you can right-click on the Sheet tab and select View Code. When the VBA window appears, open the first drop-down and change General to the sheet in question. Press Enter after the opening line of code and type application.calculate. Now go back to your file and each row you select will highlight automatically. With our active row all sorted out, let's talk about columns. You can highlight the active column range instead by managing the conditional formatting rule we created and changing all the row references to column. Pretty easy, right? If you wanted to highlight both the active rows and columns in the range, we need to alter the formula a little. I'll go back to our existing rule and after the equal sign, I'll insert the start of an OR function. At the end of the formula, I'll add a comma and include the same formula we used for the row. Make sure you add the extra closing parentheses and then apply the updated formatting rule. Now both the row and column of the active cell are highlighted like a target, but the yellow is too bland for my liking. How about we add some more helpful formatting and give the active row a different color than the column? I'll go back to our rule again and convert it back to only highlight the column. Let's change the color to something more soothing to the eye. Next, click the button to duplicate the rule, and now edit the duplication, changing the column references to row references. I'll pick a different fill color and change the font to bold. And let's select a custom border for the row. Click OK and apply the new rules. This looks much better, and I seriously doubt you'll lose your place going forward. And as you've just seen, you can format your active cells in several different ways. Feel free to apply some custom borders, varying colors, or simply highlight a single row if that gives you the help you need. Now, for those of you who see this method as overkill, this next video will teach you an alternative you can use for more than just a case of jumpy eyes.